storm show. It's a storm show.
Kaya is going to be putting Nicki on the docket, and a lot of the barbs are not coming after Kaya simply because she's going to be talking about Nicki. What you guys have to understand is that Kaya do not give a damn. Anybody can get it on Kaya's docket. It could be her own family members that will. She's even addressed them on her show and say that she don't know them. And by saying you don't know somebody, you are halfway addressing them. But I say all that to say I wanted to put up the screenshot. She said, "We the People versus Nick Van Dykes." How did she come up with this? You would be in charge with doing anything for the clout, like Cardi B said. Now, Kaya, you know you done went after Cardi too, so we ain't gonna act like Cardi's milk is clean. You know, Cardi milk got a little stuff in it that make you go like that, but you ain't heard that from me, but you heard it from me, but you heard it from my mouth, and I'm not gonna say allegedly. You were living with the pedo and now working with the pedo and a well-known snitch. This is why Wow. I'm not even going to read the rest of that, but as you can see, it got really dirty there at the end. And a lot of you guys are like, wait a minute. Why is she going so hard on Nicki? Like, we already know who Nicki's husband is. We already know that she wore with 6ix9ine. We're going to talk about that later. Here's the thing between Kaya and Nicki. Kaya actually does not have a personal issue with Nicki, but Nicki represents and is symbolic of the destruction of the Queen's Court and of what she had with Maddie. So Nicki Minaj, whenever she see Nicki on the screen, it will always bring back bad memories. Just like whenever Kaya sees Trina anywhere or hears her name, you could even see the wheels in her head turn and she shapeshifts and goes into attack mode because Trina dissed her 20 years ago and she's never been able to let that go. And that's just the truth. Like, damn, you drag somebody for 20 years, that takes dedication. I'm a professional grudge holder. It's in my DNA. But let me tell you something. It takes skill and dedication to drag somebody for 20 damn years. Back when the whole Queen Supreme Court stuff was going on, as you guys already know, Nicki was supposed to basically produce the show and bring the show to a bigger network and really put Kaya and T.S. Madison on the main screen. Now, the only issue that Nicki and the potential network had with Kaya, which is why Kaya started to really not like Nicki, she already didn't want to deal with her at first. T.S. Madison has said it, and Kaya's brother has said it too. Kaya is just not a people person. And y'all, what y'all gotta know and what y'all do not know is that she's been screwed over so many times in the industry. In the beginning, when she would try to go to studios, producers trying to screw her, they just really thought she was a hoe. That's why she got a song called "I've Been Called a Bitch, But I Never Been Called a Hoe." And so she was raised to be aggressive like that, but especially in this industry, early on, she learned real quick that she was even gonna have to be more aggressive to really just not get ran through like everybody else. Shout out to Olivia. And so as time went on, you saw the Queen Supreme Court change because Madison is more trying to commercialize the show, and Kaya was like, we good enough how we are, we good where we at, we the talent, they need us. In addition to that, Kaya was not exactly happy with the terms of the contract and with the terms of the agreement. Now here's another issue they had too. Just like when Tasha and I interviewed Madison, Madison showed me the paperwork that both Madison and Kaya signed for this network. Shout out to E. And another issue they had is that the E Network had told Nicki to tell Madison to tell Kaya, because Kaya wouldn't even really communicate with Nicki. Is look, she can't be saying the stuff she's saying about Andy. Kaya felt like, you ain't gonna tell me what I can say. So she already didn't want to deal with Nicki then. Okay, Kaya, we are Kardashian friendly. You can't be going off on Khloe. And then when I heard Madison say that part, I was like, well, damn, I can't work with E Network. We Alexandria Kardashian, I got a few tips to you to make sure that this never happens again in your life, because you know you love nigga ain't shit, because in your head you always gonna be the ugly one, you always gonna be the fat girl, you always gonna be the ugly Kardashian that's never as pretty as Kim and never as pretty as Kourtney. I went ahead and signed it. I seen her signature on the paperwork. It was E Network all day long. But Nicki will always symbolize where her and Madison's relationship made a bad turn. Nicki represents the commercialism. Nicki represents the censorship. Nicki represents that divide that came. Because before Nicki came around, everything was all good between them, at least from Kaya's perspective. But when you start adding people in and you want to go Hollywood when Kaya is comfortable where she's at, it was never going to work.
It's a storm show. It's a storm show.